up early in the morning. Gotta get it quick while they yelling. I trust no foe that can block it. They ain't really have it. Fail is a heaven, not an option. I roll so low that I got it. Ain't no lie that I'm better. Sitting back, inhale, turn it up. I glow, let them catch a check. Get the next side glow. Get it clean with the vet from Raps. I glow. Hey, what's up? What's up? What's up? Welcome, welcome, welcome to another installment of Late with GK. Okay, so this is installment number 8. All right, we're truly, truly thankful for all of you guys that have tuned in last week and the week before. And if you've caught any of our other streams, salute to you, of course. And if it is your first time here tonight, welcome. Welcome in, of course. There are two things that we just simply ask here. Real easy. Okay, number one, of course, is drop us a comment. Let us know exactly where you are watching this from. Okay, it's great. It's great to know. It's great to kind of, you know, reshuffle the geography skills and a bit of the knowledge base. And just good to know where everyone is hollering from. All right, so let us know. Let us know in the comment section. Or if you feel compelled to write us a comment with anything that's displayed tonight, by all means, be our guest. The second thing, of course, is hitting that arrow, okay? The icon on the bottom there. Real easy. It's going to take you about 2 seconds. Click share and let all your peoples know that we are on tonight. All right? Easy. That's the two things. That's all. That's about it. Apart from that, feel free just to kick back, chillax, and kick it with me. All right? So Late with GK is, of course, I come through. I share a bit about the vibes that I've been working with, you know, to get me through the week. Of course, recommendations are always important, of course, and I get to share a bit about my thoughts and opinions on a couple of things here and there, and I get to catch up with some great friends and solid mates. All right, so that's what it is, and if it ain't that, then it ain't this, if that makes sense. All right, so yeah, that's Late with GK. Tonight we got an action-packed lineup or action-packed program for everyone out there to enjoy, okay? So stay tuned, don't go anywhere else, because this is the place to be, okay? If you are a bit wondering what's going on, it's okay, just relax, we got you here. But we've got our first listing or first recommendation and serving for you all. All right, now we believe here that good music is like good food. It deserves to be shared, it deserves to be distributed, and it deserves to be recommended. All right, so these are a couple of joints from our playlist that we wanted to share out to you guys. Also, shout outs to everyone out there that shared in their vibes as well. That's what it's about, right? Community, let's get it. All right, so without further ado, here is the first serving of your Vibes of the Week. Check it out. You know how we do, we just do it, do it, do say.
Skunking, grooving, under pressure. Yeah, skunking, grooving. Under the pressures of life, and it's tough. Now stay down, mama, time, pick it up. Now bother with the down, full style, strictly up, full vibes. Now pick it up.
So good when you do.
Queen up on the throne. Don't waste time with the music in your ears. days like any Q-tip. Used to face time with a blue steel reggae bass line. Mama lose it, and I'm on a poly. Watch it, build a rhythm, put a song upon it. Now them all up on me, say them bother than me. So me kill them, I study them, man, I tell me. Them not understand me, but them say them loving the flow.
I hope you enjoyed that serving of Vibes of the Week. Now, for those that know, growing up in the neighborhood, when you are doing any type of recording, there's always going to be one guest on your recording. And yes, that is the airplanes. Okay, the airplanes that fly over your recording setup and feature themselves in your song. All right, so salute to all of those producers as well as artists doing their thing from the comfort of their home. Speaking of comfort, that's exactly what we want to provide you over here, right? So if you are at home, get comfy. If you're not at home, wherever you may be, we just want to make sure that you are sitting solid, sitting tight, and of course, enjoying our program for tonight. Now, one thing that I know I've encountered recently, especially in the last couple of weeks, is the weather. All right, now, I know it's been getting cold over the last couple of weeks, but shit, this week was cold. This week was fucking cold. Yeah, I mean, was it cold for you guys? Like, fuck, it was cold. It was like real freezing. And don't you find it like interesting as well when you think you're okay and you know you have a shower or whatnot, and then you head outside and fuck, it's cold, it's freezing. All right, so stay warm. Everyone, stay warm. It's that season, but you still gotta stay safe. So be sure you are being a legend in your bubble. And make sure you are staying within your bubble and staying warm, okay? Here I am acting like I'm someone to tell you to stay warm. You know what? Just stay warm, stay safe, and be sure to, you know, cover up the neck and get the long sleeves going, because that weather is ice cold and it ain't no joke, all right? So, what part of the country or whereabouts are you guys tuning in from? Like, let us know how cold it is. In your area or in your city, let us know what are some of your tricks to stay warm. Like, one that I've seen shared quite recently, actually it gets shared every winter. Yeah, it does. It gets shared every winter, is leaving the oven open. Leaving the oven open to keep the whole house warm. That works. That works. Like, I've never had anyone out there tell me that shit don't work. That actually works. So that one gets shared every winter. If there are any other tips and tricks out there, let us know. Let us know what you've used in the past, or maybe what you're still currently using to keep yourself warm. Yeah. So let us know. Let us know. Are the hot water bottles still in play? Because I know a couple of years back, motherfuckers were just getting burnt. Yeah. Getting burnt bad. So I'm not too sure if those are super popular as well. And of course, the retail game, I mean, everything's kind of open now, so you can head out and get warm clothes. All right, I know I'm kind of rambling on, but just stay warm, okay? Stay warm. Stay warm, because it is freezing. You know that weather is not playing. Not at all. But without further ado, here is your next servings for Vibes of the Week.
You know how we do, we just do it. Sit at the top and they come for your head.
Come for your head.
Come for your head.
Come for your head.
Come for your head. Stoop to their level, you're better off dead.
So who gonna kill me? That's less than likely. I hear no fear, no even inside me. You took a lot of game, right around, no hype. See, killers move in silence, reason for more sleep. I saw that white noise, just noise, relax, G. Spinning around house from home, I secured. Another good reason, nobody gonna kill team. Guilty, get shots, but we dope, and that's it.
Young woman, get it twisted. They don't know how to act. This whole game ain't gonna change for a piece of that ass. It ain't me, I keep it G with the style and class. Ward life I'm all about. You can read about mine. A long line full of hustlers, real gangsters that ride. Dressed up in all black, teardrops in her eyes. If you're fucking with my money, I ain't letting it slide.
People sell them souls, I ain't into that business. Eyes all over my business, I see red lights, slip wrist, get twisted, get lifted, bear witness to get witness. On one, don't start nothing, I'll end up on my hit list. But them don't want it, friendly, but them don't want it. Demonic, as if I'm haunted, possessed, puffing and chronic.
Come make my jeans, come help me out.
Just me, like
like a bomb straight from murder to what happens. I got cyclops fish in my water, a nation of Pacific lambs to the slaughter. Three eyes for my son, an extra foot for my daughter.
All right, awesome. Now, speaking of music, what's great about music that I feel anyway now is the numerous outlets that you can use to consume music. Okay, so we're all familiar now with streaming platforms. We're all familiar now with YouTube and you name it. There's so much platforms out there that people can, you know, get on or even share their music and share what they're thinking and feeling creatively. So it's super dope to see some of these artists just come out of nowhere, you know, and drop some heat for everyone to enjoy. Okay, so that's dope. Also, I know I say this every week, but it's the truth, man. With nightclubs and places for people to congregate and enjoy music and dance, I mean, it's been a bit limited lately. You can agree on that shit. So shout outs to all of our DJs jumping online and entertaining everyone, okay? You may have your own opinions, but hey, that's cool. That's cool. And that's the coolest thing about music now. The question I was just wanting to bring up though is, you know, is consuming too much music a good thing or is that a bad thing? But that's just the general question. Like, what do you think? Do you think consuming too much music is a good thing or a bad thing? I mean, you can never get enough of good music, right? Good music is good music. But I mean, yeah, because I know a few people that are more than, you know, they're using more than one platform to listen to the music, different reasons. But hey, what do you reckon? Or do you feel that artists are not putting out enough music for you to enjoy? Hey, these are just little things that I just wanted to bring up, because these are things that I was thinking about throughout the week. All right, you just let me know what you reckon. That'll be cool. Drop us a comment, let us know. Also, just a salute to everyone out there that's, of course, back on the grind. I've been seeing a couple of our artists out there doing their thing, you know, of course, getting back on the hustle, getting back on the grind, and pushing out what they've been planning to do before this whole COVID pandemic hit. So, salute to everybody out there that's, of course, back on the grizzy, doing their thing, and make sure you support local talent. Now, there's something that I'll bring up later, but that's the question for this part anyway, is you know, is too much music good to consume? Okay, but yeah, so shout outs to everybody out there on the grind doing their thing, carrying on with the plan that be. All right, but you know what, I know I'm blabbering on, so without further ado, I'm gonna introduce the next section. And here is your next serving of Vibes of the Week. Check it out.
You know how we do, we just do it. Do it, do it.
You can flip this soap melodic. Yeah. And slide these flows provided. Get your chips. Yeah. It's so exciting.
Doing this shit, moving this shit, moving.
Chilling. Like, wait a second. Get up and get it, mommy, raise them, no bitch. Drop a classic. Make a second. Turn down your radios, cause they don't make them like this.
Dance merengue with your mama. Dance merengue, know you wanna. A little Mark Anthony, it'll bring it right back to me. Dance merengue with your mama. Dance merengue, know you wanna. A little Mark Anthony, it'll bring it right back. Hey, goddamn, how you did it like that? Low skirt with a booty underneath it like that.
I just had a summer in Soho. Go to the friend, girlfriend sticking like an amphibian. Girlfriend with me like the gang of the clan, cause she know where I'm from. By the stance of my hands and the fact that the city know my name, that's him. And the fact that they got my back, I ain't taking shit back. Know that I am off in kickflip bins, looking like Eric Costa. Stick shit van for the whole damn squad. And fist clear smash, made a hit, Ron Artest.
From NY to CA, me and Ski back on the road. Asking who pushing plates, and I ain't talking getting swole. Yeah. You taste the orange tree of citrus every time it smokes. Nathan for Super Sour D, riding up with ghosts. Roll out the carpet, cookie treatment, exotics we chiefing. Cookies. Trap out apartments, now it's roofless every time we feasting.
Hey. I hope you enjoyed that latest installment of Vibes of the Week. Now, if you just joined us, Vibes of the Week is our way of recommending dope tunes for your playlist. So, we say it all the time, you know, good music is like good food. We believe it deserves to be shared, regardless of your walk of life or where you do come from, because music for everyone means different things. I did mention before that with music, you can attach memories to it. Sometimes it's a feeling, sometimes it can make you feel as one, or for some, it actually helps express how, you know, you feel. Easy. So it's a no-brainer, right? No-brainer at all. Now, this is a section we call GH Backstories, where I share a little bit about some of the music that I've released, and I also take you through a quick little backstory on how that track may have come about and may have come together. Okay, now, this next track is called GK Nation. Now, for some of those that don't know, GK Nation is a you know, a coined term for those that support the music, those that support the shows, and of course the thought process behind how we put these songs together. So that's the umbrella of the whole track. It starts from the title. So GK Nation is pretty much you. You know, you that tune in every week, you that still stream our music, and you people out there that show nothing but love. Alright, that's all of you guys. So I'm super appreciative of that. So that's where the benchmark of the song starts. It starts with the title there. Of course, it's a hashtag as well. Feel free to hashtag that wherever you are. Now, GK Nation, that was a song that was about, you could say, 15 years in the making. Okay, so that got released in 2017 off the album GK23. It was actually originally, as a concept, given to us on a beat CD. So I was fortunate to hang around some of the dopest engineers to come out of Otara in South Auckland, and some of those that actually helped mold and form what was coined as the South Auckland sound. Okay, so shout outs to Alan Tongi, aka X, who originally gave us a beat CD full of like 12 tracks. 12 tracks we weren't allowed to give to anyone. So that CD was pretty much gold, okay? It's gold. You don't want to give that to anyone. So, like, long story short, I know it was originally, that production actually was originally supposed to be featured on another classic album, which we will probably touch base on soon. So it was actually was supposed to be featured for another artist, okay? So us being the youngins at the time, or those that are trying to come up and trying to, you know, do something with these tracks, we were fortunate to get those tracks sent to us on the beat CD. Now, not many people could even tackle the feat that was ahead of us. So when we first got the CD, man, you hear it now, it didn't sound anything like that. Okay, so I mean, it's a hardcore track, pretty hard hitting, and whoever was gonna jump on it needed to be A100 with it. Okay, so long story short, as like most stories, the years go by, the years carry on, the years linger, it goes on, and the beat CD still kind of sits there. By then, you could say 5 years had passed. 5 years before? Yeah, 5 years had passed, the CD was still there, and we managed to, of course, get the track ripped off the CD, and we put it into a studio session. Not only that, we wanted to, of course, embody the support that we were getting at the time. So we'd already released the first album at that point. We were working on the next couple of tracks for GK23. And at the same time, we could feel the love from you all. We could feel it. We could feel the support. And it was an ode to you guys. It was an ode to how your guys' energy was pushing what we were doing in the studio. So, you know how they say, timing is everything. And I mean, it kind of works because it's a music story. So timing is everything, you know, being cohesive, as they could say. So timing was everything because at that time, you know, there was no one coming out of Otara on the hip hop tip at that time, okay? There was no one coming out of Otara on the hip hop tip just representing for the neighborhood. So we were just glad to take that energy, take the energy that we were getting from everyone out there, and of course accumulate it together, mix it up, and use that as the basis and the foundation of the writing style of the track. All right, so we had to quickly switch it up and get on the track. Now, previously to that though, we'd probably only performed over the track with my old group. Shout out to Crossbreed. We probably only performed over the track, I think, twice or a couple of times. That's about it. And then we didn't really use it. So fast forward, I know I'm hopping everywhere, but bear with me, it's been quite some time. Fast forward to the studio, we now end up putting everything together. We now end up bouncing off ideas in the studio, Siavani, Groove Junkie, myself, and then we had the team come in and now and then, all right? So as you can hear, shout outs to Gap Mantis too. Gap Man was on that track as well with the shredding, fucking dope. So now we're in there, we're firing off ideas, we're bouncing off ideas. Okay, cool. Yeah, what would sound good here with the music production, what would sound here? And we wanted to just pay homage to the New York hip hop scene as well, because New York had come through with The Rock in the 80s. Okay, so you had, you know, the whole Def Jam scene and Rick Rubin come through and implement rock with hip hop and merge that. We wanted to pay tribute to that. Not only that, we wanted to also keep it edgy, keep it edgy, but at the same time, keep it dope enough for parents to still play around their kids. Alright, you gotta understand, man, songwriting isn't for the weak-hearted or faint-hearted, okay? There's a lot of thought that goes into it, most of the time anyway. So we wanted to really tackle that as well. You could hear on the first verse as well, come through. We just come through with it real early, and just smash it through. So the gate plan was, you know, high energy, high octane, go right through, shred it, and let it build as you go along. So when you hear the song, you actually hear the song build as it goes through. Now near the end of the song, because I'm just going to give you time to go out there and then check that out, near the end of the song, then you hear the crowd interaction. Okay, now the crowd interaction on the actual track, of course, other boys or other crew, so salute to the boys that came through and laced down some vocals that we directed them to do. They come through and they come through with a massive ass chant. You can hear that. You can fucking hear that chant. It roars. Okay, so that all comes through and it's almost like an army. It's almost like a nation. It's almost like a group of believers that are yelling, that are screaming, that are shouting. So we wanted to implement that. We also took into account that with music, whether it be headphones or on your speaker, that's gonna keep you motivated, man. Whether you're training or, you know, you're studying for a test, like, that's what it is. It could be used as fuel, it can be used as a tool, it can be used as a vehicle for you to fully get in tune. Now, if you don't understand what I'm saying, if I'm sounding a bit fucking crazy right now, that's cool. But for some of you guys that do understand where I'm coming from, and especially you artists and producers out there, you know exactly where I'm coming from. Like, when you're in tune, everything fits. Everything is smooth like butter. For fucking sure, right? Okay, cool. So that's the basis of the track. So if we wanted to come through with high octane energy, you know, we wanted to be in your face, but still paying homage to those that came before us, and at the same time, keep a knocking enough for these parents to drop their kids off, listening to that, you know, motivating the young people as well. So pretty much it was a massive gumbo of ideas that we put in. But it's more than that as well, because if we break it down, if you listen to Gapman's guitar on the chorus, just before the chorus drops, like on the end of my verse, just before the chorus drops, you hear him shred that note, or you hear him hit that note. Now, I remember when we were in the studio and we were putting all this together, we needed something that was going to get the attention of the ear. That was simply just going to come out and reach out and grab you if you weren't already invested into the song by then. We needed something to come through and grab you and pull you into it and feel the energy. And it's almost like a siren. It was like a siren calling out the crowd. All right. Now, if I'm sounding a bit crazy, hey, that's what it is. Fuck it. Okay. But at the time, that was the mode that we were in. And we wanted to, of course, build a visual in your head through the audio, of course, so you can get the energy and where we were at in the studio. Because sometimes the energy in a studio can't always be, you know, recooked up. So when you got it, you got it. Okay, so long story short, this is a high octane energy song. It's simply written to motivate you as well. Now, for some out there who still don't know how I got my MC name, my actual MC name, of course, is Giant Killer. My middle name's David, from the Bible of David versus Goliath. And, you know, in the long run, anything that stops you from getting forward or moving forward into where you want to be, I believe is a giant. We believe are giants. And I mean, every day we face them. Every day we face a challenge and an obstacle. And I've told the story many times, but it's the truth though. Like, if you can get over that hurdle, if you can move forward, or if you can just adjust yourself a little bit just to get forward, we believe, you know, you've killed the giant. So that's what it is. It's an umbrella song for everybody out there who may need it, who may need a bit of a pickup, who may need a bit of a word just to get their brain motivated or kind of refocus you. You know, just to fucking kill your targets and smash it out. Not literally, but you know what I mean, mentally or anything out there that's actually holding you back from getting to where you need to be. Not that I'm a motivational speaker or what, but that's what the song embodies. And the thing is, if you're out there and you're looking for something that's gonna put you into gear, there's no doubt about it that I have super confidence in the production of this track, as well as the songwriting of this track, that you may find what you're looking for with this track. All right, without further ado, here it is, GK Nation from the album GK23. Enjoy and be sure to share this, all right? Drop a comment and let me know what you think.
Excuse me now, ladies and gentlemen, eyes to the front. Giant killer nation, about to say them for the top. And we be ripping and rapping, the neck of giants we snapping. Sicker than a psycho on a microphone, we be smacking. Army of winners beginning to kill him and fill him with feelings. We're bigger, quicker, with bigger pencils, pick him and penicillin. Ceiling can fall, we burning it all. Got an innovative nation who be ready to call. Ready to fight, bring it on any day of the night. Never giving up because we know we fighting what's right.
I hope you enjoyed the GH backstory with our title this week, which was GK Nation. That is off the album GK23, which was released in 2017, produced by Siavani and Groove Junkie, engineered from the whole team as well. All right, so I know that was a little snippet right there, but you can stream the full song today on all streaming platforms, all right? Spotify, Apple Music, Tidal. All right, and if you want to flick a couple of pingers our way, you can do so through iTunes and Google Play. Now, I see some of you guys have let me know what streaming platforms you listen to music on, and thanks to everyone that dropped the comment tonight. Truly appreciate it. If you missed our show and you're just tuning in now, it's okay. Run this replay back. And of course, if you are interested in more vibes, feel free to check out our other streams as well. But until further notice, this is GK, your host of Late with GK. It's been a pleasure. It's been an honor, of course, to kick it with you tonight. And stay safe, stay warm, and always remember, groove house, baby, to the death. Check it out. Peace.